Hello and welcome to the World of Madness. Sorry, I'm not getting my episodes up quite quickly, but I should be trying to get a few more. Got an idea that'll make me a bit more interested in playing. It's been a little odd without, it's been hard to get back into vanilla with really no mods. We do have the mods like the bed and stuff like that, but most of them still aren't working right now due to 1.9 stuff. I've been hearing a zombie, but I can't see him. Huh. Oh well. Must be in the tunnels or something below my house. Yeah, as I was saying, so I think today we're going to try and do a few things. We're going to show off progress on the building, as usual. I'm going to probably try a few more enchantments. I got a few things enchanted since last time, I think. Maybe. Finally, I'm thinking we're going to be actually trying to do a redstone project on the server. I'm thinking about trying to go for a computer in survival. I've never finished one of my computers, even on a creative server, so what remains that idea we'll see. But I was thinking about maybe try to start a program counter. Now, I'm not sure if I want to try and build it on this plains out here, and then get it all designed and then try and build a structure, city-like structure around it or something to hide it. Or we build it in our bunker down there that we're slowly expanding out on. So, let's start off by progress on the building, since that's really all I've been doing on here all this time, and haven't been playing enough on my own to get enough resources, so hopefully with the enchantments so we can mine stone a lot more effectively. So, I took down the structure here. In the creative, I decided what I was going to do. I'm going to go for stone stairs with stone slab centers, I believe. Though, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to do that on this first floor just because of how high it is. I think you can replace a stone stair upside down. So, it's just going to be... Oops, that one's sideways. We'll go grab that. Guess I'm not going to be able to place that one without just walking over there. Yeah, so we're just going to ring this around. Yeah, placing stairs isn't the most fun. But the idea, I think, is... I think I like it. Yeah, it's going to be this textured idea, but... Because I couldn't decide on whether or not just doing it using this. This thing is the divider with the slab straight above. But I kind of like this two-tiered look. Gives a bit more depth to the pillars and makes them kind of more interesting, in my opinion. Yeah, so that is our idea with... I think I've decided on stone bricks, because we don't have... If we had smooth stone slabs, I'd definitely be using those. But this is probably the closest in the consistency that we have. So that's why I'm going with this. Now let's take a look at that. I don't have any on me. I was out of stone from building other things. But yeah, I think that's going to look reasonable. I was wanting to do a wood accent, but it just doesn't feel right. I like the cold stone nature we've been going for with this build, and I don't quite want to ruin it. So, another thing that was done is if we head up here to the overhang, we've got all the windows in. I finally decided on a way of doing them that I quite like. I like this little curved structure. If it exists like this, it looks kind of weird here, but it's fine. It goes into the central ones that stick out, but curves into the ones that are ahead. So it keeps the design we had before, and the windows look quite good on the inside, in my opinion. I haven't figured out the end yet. I haven't put too much thought into this, how this is going to look. It's probably going to get all... It should get all replaced with smooth stone. I just hadn't... been ignoring it right now. I'll fix that, really. I want to get the interior rooms done. I need to figure out how I'm partitioning these walls apart, the rooms and such. On the inside, probably just going to divide them straight on the borders here. Like, this is going to be a dividing room, unless it's a double-wide room. We'll see. Probably going to have a lot of double-wide rooms. I like larger rooms, and this base actually is quite ginormous. I keep forgetting. It seems small sometimes, but really it's a huge amount of space up here. Same for the... Oh, that is the second floor, but yeah, both floors have got the windows in. Still nothing special on the roof yet, just the same as it always had, the little claws hooking over, got my ladders everywhere. I haven't got much transportation, but something I also spent a bit of time on is I have decided the building is not tall enough after all that work. And so we increased the height by however much that is. A few more floors, three or four more floors. But I think it gives a much more impressive look because it disappeared. The proportions of this building just felt wrong compared to the enormous overhang over there. So I need to make it a little taller. Continued our same pattern of the alternating windows in the center and the just the indents off to the side. I got these two done. That one's mostly there. And I ran out of smooth stone at that point, so we didn't get this side done. Also missing the frame bar across this side. And the top, we'll figure it. Still not quite sure on the spot yet. It's probably just going to look like pretty much like it is now, but probably striped windows across it in the center, so row of blocks with the row of the black tinted windows in the center, as everything else is. Can't believe it's already almost nighttime. And floor is all going to be same pattern, and I believe I've decided I'm going to go with the staircase over on that side of the building, just to give that some depth. And on this side, to give it depth, we're going to repeat the pattern from below the structure up along the side. And maybe we'll try and emboss a logo or something onto the side of it. Try and figure out a design and put it on there. There's a building locally in here that has a large smooth wall, but with a pretty cool logo on the side. Kind of thinking of that for inspiration for the flat walls. So yeah, I'd probably be repeating this pattern up the top, just to give it some depth. Probably not these bits here, they're more representative of these columns. They're actually at the correct column spacing, but just this design up the side. Cows still need to be moved. Haven't been breeding them too much lately, so not too much of a problem with their noise. But yeah, I quite like the look of it, and if we go from a distance, we can see the relative scale now. I find is a lot more impressive. Yeah. I just, it's meant to be big and impressive, this building. That's really what it's meant for. Still probably need something more on that side or behind it. But I think it's quite nice. And maybe there'll be a, could have a second layer of these off the side, but the building would have to be pretty tall to compensate for that. It's just a matter of proportions. So yeah, what we're going to do, we're going to go and I guess I'm going to get a couple more levels so we can try another enchantment. I believe there was something I was looking for on one of them. I think there was a protection four, something like that, or... Oh, power four, there's a powerful bow I could get. And I think that might be a fun enchantment. Though I'm not sure if I want to waste three levels on that. I haven't been getting levels that much recently. Breeding the animals, probably should go back to doing that, because that's how I got the majority of my levels before then. Pickies. Not as noisy now. Oh, and something I didn't realize. You can have, and this was just purely by coincidence, you can have a 2x2 one of these spruce trees. I didn't know they existed. Apparently I am quite out of touch with the times. That one just grew naturally when got an overcrowding of saplings from the autoplant module did that. So... anyway, it's almost night. I think I'm going to take a break here, get a couple more levels, see what we can get enchanting now. Maybe they've changed since I last checked. If not, if I can get 33, I'm still hoping to get boots with a feather falling on them. That would be very nice when working up at the top of that, which even at the old mark, that was an instant death from full. That was an instant death there. So up at the full height, yeah, I'm pretty much boned up there if I happen to fall. Alright, I'll see you guys when I get back. Well, it looks like we found a cave. A little creeper up there decided to walk through the lava to come get to me and get stuck there in the water. Huh. Didn't hear it. Suddenly heard this ravine here from the boiling lava. Let's clear some of that off. Maybe the creeper will path over to us. Or be a derp. There we go. So I made the shield, finally getting into 1.9 stuff. Because I miss blocking with stuff. Though I do kind of like the axe. The axe is quite fun to play with. That's an interesting cave. So I did go caving earlier in the week. Finally got over my fear of doing it after the first expedition. Wish I recorded Outpost Bravo, because you could just see me just basically going through the caves, not really fearing much until I found skeletons. Skeletons ruin everything, apparently. Oh, bat's burning itself in the lava. Let's figure out where we are. That looks interesting up there, that little shaft there. I think it's just what it is, just a little shaft. Hey. Hello up there. Not that suicidal to jump down here, are you? Oh yeah, you are. What? Just when did they explode that quickly? Jeez, this was prudent on the blocking, but what was that? I've never seen that before. That's new to me. I kind of don't want to be in this cave anymore. That was a zombie up there, I'm assuming. Yeah, there he is. Come on, through the lava, like an idiot. Okay, stay away. I don't want to be burned. The thing I'm looking for right now is I really want to find a spawner. I need XP and haven't not quite ready to build a full-out mob trap, but I had found a spawner before. It's an outpost. There's a spawner in Outpost Bravo in the maze of caves down there. I had loot from it too. I had I think I had some more horse armor and what was it? What's it called? Record. Gun from one of the places. This doesn't feel safe at all. Let's get away from the lava. Get some torches out. And I don't know how that zombie spawned there. Must have been there the entire time. How far into this rabbit hole? Oh! Okay, apparently we've seen this before. Interesting. Remember being here. I don't really want to be going up. I want to stay near the bottom. But if it means a spawner, I will go up. But I haven't heard any signs of one yet. I don't know why I have the bow out. That's not going to help me. No, don't get me wrong. I'm good with a bow. It's not going to help it. I don't know why I'm using the scroll wheel. I never use the scroll wheel. But hey, let's get some lapis. We need that. We're gonna need that for enchanting. And yeah, caving's kind of dangerous when you're taking one of your most valuable items with you. I do have a silk touch, but it's not unbreaking. Oh, need some coal though. It's not unbreaking, so I'll be trying to get an unbreaking book to anvil onto it. But haven't had that yet. So we're just out here with our fortune pick right now. Because it's an unbreaking 3 fortune 3 pick, so that's quite useful. No, let's not go into that. Let's not dig into that hole. We're gonna spend forever if we just go for all the iron we see. Or all the coal we see. So, I guess while we're caving here, since a bit impromptu, I guess we can talk about what the plans are if we're gonna do it for the computer I was thinking of. Now, these always seem to be too ambitious. Being a software guy, I like to come up with software specifications. So that'd be a great design for a processor. I want this feature in assembly. I like assembly, so I kind of have those ideas. But and then I realize those are really they don't translate well into building a simplistic processor when you've never actually finished completing one. I have built ALUs. I've built registers. I've built memory. I've just never finish the control logic, the actual C part in a CPU. Kind of the important thing. Pretty important part of it. But there's lava under this. If I go down, there's going to be lava under this. Oop. Apparently not. No one claim... No, I didn't claim onto that bet. Shh. I didn't bet anything. So... stands for belly. Here, we're going to need redstone. We also need iron for pistons. Pistons are quite important. Let's not bring up that. Yeah, so what I was thinking of, the width doesn't matter too much. I was thinking of maybe reducing it to a 4-bit concept rather than 8-bit. And no, I'm not building 16 because all the adders and all that kind of stuff start getting a bit more complicated. That's due to the signal length of redstone being 16 blocks, and basically every adder and stuff like that is going to be two blocks wide to be the most efficient, or 2x wide being the most space and speed efficient. So they're typically that, and 8 times 2 is 16, so you end up with the word size that matches really nicely up to the redstone length. You just have to be prudent of that while building it, but that's not really an issue. It is a possibility to go down to 4-bit, but because it might reduce some complexities with signal length and stuff like that, it would be a lot simpler to build for. It's just probably would be less useful. It would be slower because most data you're going to operate is not going to be limited between either negative 8 and positive 7 or 0 and 16 or 0 and 15. So you tend to have to use instructions that carry with a lot of carries, like add with carry and stuff like that. You probably should have those in any decent instruction set anyway, but when you're when you can get away with an 8-bit, when you can build an 8-bit for not much more cost, the speed improvements would be useful, because 256 can represent a lot of stuff. So if you're using it for, say, keeping track of items, we have 64 stacks as the biggest stack in Minecraft. So, you know, it can have an issue. You could store that quite easily. We could build a 6-bit computer? Yeah, 6-bit. We could build a 6-bit computer and keep track of up to 64 values. That might be an interesting experiment. Be kind of a different type of architecture to program for, but hey, that might be the challenge. So where, going on to tangent, where does this lead? When was I here? This is weird. Oh, okay, I think I remember where this is. This is going to lead back to, yeah, okay, I know where we are now. This leads back to where we started off about here, yeah. So there's our iron pit, and there's our staircase up from the branch mine, which is now turned into just a regular cave-in expedition right now. The other thing about doing these cave-in expeditions, it'd be nice to light up more areas so that in the future we can make a mob tower. Might even make that soon, because the lack of XP for enchanting is kind of a little bit annoying at this point. It's just overlooking the ravine again, so I can build. That's enough lighting for that. It's probably a few spots where the mobs can spawn this. It's not going to be perfect. Don't expect it to be. Just expect a zombie not to drop down onto my head. Oh, if they can, maybe there might be one up there. There might be enough space there. Something I really like is arrows that can shoot a torch, like in some of the mod packs. You can get you can shoot torches wherever you want. Like, I'd love to be able to just light up that area there so nothing can ever spawn. But that's probably not going to happen right now. Well, we do have those spectral arrows that I don't really know what they do. I don't remember at this point. Probably should look that up. They sound like they could be interesting. What are we talking about? Oh, computers. Let's get back to that, since we were got a bit distracted with the caves. So the word size, yeah, we're probably not going to be too picky about it, but we'll figure out what's going to be. First thing I'm probably going to build, we might even get started on that today, is building a program counter. That program counters is a register that also, well, if it's just going to be a dedicated unit like most ideas I have for computers, it's going to be a register that can store data, but also with a built-in binary counter. It's a binary counter that you can update the value of. So normal binary counters just count up, but to make it special into a program counter, you want an option to you want to be able to add an arbitrary number to, well, not add an arbitrary number. We could do that through the ALU, but we want to be able to set it to an arbitrary number. To add, if we want to add, you would load it in through the bus in the to the process. So there's ALU and add the value there, store it back out to the PC is the jump. So the program counter points to the memory. Now, something I've always been thinking about with my processors is the architecture. I've always, well, all my plans have always been von Neumann architecture, which has a shared code and data section. The program is the same as the memory it runs from, which means if you have a ROM, you don't want to write to the ROM, but that's not an issue, really. You can still have the program space and the data space be the same. But the downside to this, for our purposes, would be word size. It requires that the instructions be the same size as your base unit of data, so in an 8-bit computer, you'd have an 8-bit instruction. Though there's nothing saying you can't have a multi-byte instruction, where you read one part of it, and then you read another part. That's how processors like x86 and the computer you're probably watching this on work. Although if you're watching this on a tablet, it might be ARM-based, which uses it's a 32-bit architecture, but every instruction word is 32 bits. Not sure what I was expecting while I dug out that way. So everything's 32 bits, all the instructions fit into 30 bits. 1 byte per instruction, which also means that there's not going to be an alignment thing. You can't, like, if your program can't jump into the middle of an instruction and then all the other future instructions may be interpreted differently. That's the case on x86, and it's also used for, that trick is used for stuff like anti-debugging, and malware might use it, or some exploits might use it to, when they jump into the shared code, where they'll land in the middle of an instruction that looks hard. It's a normal harmless instruction, but if you interpret it this way, it can actually be what the attacker was looking for, a different set of instruction if you jump into the wrong spot of it, rather than the one they were intending on. So yeah, that's the thing with x86 and the multi-byte architectures. The other type of architecture we have with, instead of von Neumann, where we have the shared code and data, is we could have a Harvard architecture, which is a strict separation of code and data. You'll have a data memory and a code memory, and you can't mix between them. Code can only run from code, and data can only run from data. This also leads itself to having different data sites. Say you want 11 bits in your CPU to represent an instruction. That's what you need to make it really simple to build the CPU decoding part. You can have that as well as an 8-bit data bus. So ALU is 8-bit, all your data is 8-bit. So now everything I've been thinking is von Neumann. I kind of like von Neumann because it allows for some interesting stuff and would actually be potentially useful in a Minecraft computer to optimize speed, where you'd modify your own code to make stuff faster. Like you'd have a loop in your code that would have some hard-coded values in it just so they run faster, but you run through the code a bunch of times, and after it, you'll edit and change those values in the actual instructions itself, and just keep running the loop, using less memory and potentially being faster at the same time. No, those aren't used too much lately, so we'll see. I'm kind of tempted to try and do Harvard architecture this time, just because of the it could potentially make a simplistic decoder. So what do we get for enchanting, since we were planning on doing that? So level 30 on boots, we get a depth strider. Not too interested in going underwater at this point, so what do we get on tools right now? Unbreaking 3, wish that was on a book. We'll see what that book is then. Blast protection 4. I guess there's nothing too interesting that I'm looking for right now. Do I want a chess piece? What would a chess piece give me? Don't want to spend too many levels on stuff. Ooh, thorns, that might be. That might be nice in a pinch, but it kind of wears out your armor. I don't quite want, wouldn't want that quite on the diamond armor. Can we enchant shields? No, you can't. You can use anvil to put a couple enchantments on shields, but not shields directly. So, bow is power 4. And now, since. Ooh, flame's actually quite fun. I think we're going to go for the power 4 just to get this enchantment over with, because I don't particularly like any of the other options I'm looking at, and this might be fun to play with. Power 4 punch 2, that's not bad. Wish I had breaking. I need a bunch of breaking books, so that's why I want to get some levels going. So what do we get with a book? fire aspect. Woo. boots, please. Duels. That we might go for then, since I don't if it's gonna be silly with us. I don't want a fortune axe, they're all the same. No, I guess they are. Fortune shovel. Get all the flint in the world. Okay, so since our options are nothing I want too much, I might end up with yet another pick enchanted after this. We do have a bow. We have a really good bow now. With only a few arrows. Because I have to go find chickens, I think. Oh, another arrow there. Yeah, probably need to get some chickens. But yeah, we've got three picks right now. We've got a Fortune 3, Unbreaking 3. We've got an Efficiency 4, which is why I'm hoping for Unbreaking. Because I really want to mine cobble, and this thing really helps mining cobble. Though, these two together would be pretty fun. I just want to see how much it costs. I'm not going to combine those. I'm not going to combine these two. It's way too expensive. Oh, it's only four to make that? But it does cost me a pick. And that is the question. Silk Touched Efficiency 4 pick would be great for getting smooth stone. And Unbreak. That costs six. Fortune 3, Unbreaking 3, Efficiency 4 pick would be cool. I could get my Unbreaking, but I don't want to waste a fortune. I want to keep the efficiency for the cobble and the fortune for. Diamonds, diamonds, coal, redstone, that kind of lapis, that kind of stuff. So let's put these back in here. So the other two books that we've gotten so far are Luck of the Sea, which I believe I showed you, and Protection 3. If I get my feather falling boots, I'll probably equip them as well with Protection 3, but I'm not quite sure. I want them breaking, or what is it? There's a regeneration one. I don't believe it's just called regeneration, but. Something like that would be nice. I don't want to lose the boots when I make them. And I don't particularly want to have this many levels. So our pigs aren't grown up yet. Yeah, so I think that's going to be all for today. This is a bit short. I guess we could start on our redstone. But I think we're going to start on that next time. Which hopefully will be a sooner episode than the gaps between normally. I'm trying to get back to I want to get to the one a week that I originally said I would when I started. But yeah, structure's shaping up, need more stone, as usual, need to move into there, I want to build some room so I can actually just live in that structure, as much as I like my little structure down there, I want the big area, big chest storages, furnace rooms, enchanting rooms, all that kind of stuff in there, maybe a few offices and a living space, stuff like that, and figure out what's going to go in the main tower itself. Yeah, so, yeah. And on to redstone. It's either going to be, this island here is either going to be taken over by the computer or it's going in the bunker down there. The bunker is the harder option because it's taller than wide right now. I don't really need that height if I was going to build a computer in it. And it just takes forever to mine this out. Like, I go two blocks at a time and I usually spend like an hour or so mining in there. And it just takes a while. But yeah, it's an option. The problem with this is that mobs are gonna have to light up the computer like crazy to stop mobs from spawning. And to be fair, it'll be a bit of an eyesore. But hey, I think above ground might be the idea, just because it looks more impressive. And having to dig into a cave is probably the problem. But yeah. It'd be nice having it near the tower, then I could potentially run like data lines up and actually maybe have programs running where it lights up a torch or something like that to tell me when something's done or something like that. It'd be possible. Though I could build just little redstone machines to do that without a computer. But computer. Yeah. Alright, so I guess that'll be it for today. Or was there one thing I wanted to say? Nope, I don't remember. Alright, so I guess you guys, if you have any opinions one way or another, I feel like actually participating, maybe let me know in the comments if you think it'd be better to take over this grassy field, build it, dig out a huge-ass bunker underground to build a computer into there, maybe build it somewhere else, you got another idea? It's pretty flat over here, we'd want a pretty flat area. Alright, let me know in the comments. And I'll... I guess I fell in here last time. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.